on, trust me, trust me. You pass, I pass. Everybody pass.
We are teachers here in Sekolah Ciputra, and today we have a special coverage. We will look into academic integrity.
Now, let's find out what academic integrity means. Our reporter, Ms. Ria, is with the Diploma Coordinator, Mr. Simon.
I'm here at Sekolah Ciputra with me, Mr. Simon, as TP Coordinator of Sekolah Ciputra, and we want to find out more about academic honesty. Okay, Mr. Simon. So, what does academic honesty mean to our students?
Well, academic honesty means being trustworthy. It means setting standards for yourself so that people can believe in you and believe in the work that you do. Part of this is doing your assignments to the best of your ability and always acknowledging other people's work.
And what does academic honesty mean to parents?
To parents. Well, parents can improve academic honesty by helping their children to avoid malpractice. So firstly, encouraging your child to be on time and have good study schedules. Then taking an interest in the work that your child does and discussing where they found the information. Finally, you can make sure that your child doesn't miss any school so they get all the right information. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Simon. Back to Ms. Debbie and Mr. Brian.
Hi, Miss.
Hi, selamat pagi.
Hi, selamat pagi, Miss.
Hi, good morning.
Masuk.
Do you have any homework? Is there any homework?
Selesai.
What about I borrow you also. Yours. Come give
me.
I will just combine both of your work, okay, and make a new one, which is mine. Okay, come on.
Come on, trust me, trust me. You pass, I pass. Everybody pass. Come on, give it to me, please, please. Come on, come on. You don't have enough time. Yes, thank you.
Hello, Mr. Stewart. Do you know what double dipping is?
Hi, Peter. Double dipping is when a student reuses material for two assessments.
Can you give an example of this?
So, for example, if you studied Macbeth in English and you used it for your HL essay, you could not use the same content for your EE.
What about other subjects?
No. The teacher will outline possible double dipping issues in their DP subject, but it is up to the student to ultimately make sure they adhere to these rules. Here at Sekolah Ciputra, we believe in student agency. And now it's my turn, Peter. Can you tell me, what is collusion?
Well, Mr. Stewart, according to the IBO, collusion is, quote, supporting malpractice by another candidate, as in allowing one's work to be copied or submitted for assessment by another. In short, you are supporting malpractice by your actions. Unquote.
That's a bit complicated. Can you give me some examples?
Sure. Based on the School Assessment Procedures Manual 2020, if you let another student copy from your homework, or the teacher gives you a lab to be completed individually, but you work with other students and submit the work with only your name on it, or in an exam, test or quiz, you share your answers with other students during the assessment. You take an exam, test or quiz earlier than your peers and then you share the material with them. Those kind of things.
Thank you, Mr. Peter.
Thank you, Mr. Stewart.
Very informative presentation. And we hope you too find it useful.
Stay tuned to the end of this special coverage. Ms. Adriana has more on citations and referencing.
Thank you for watching.
Have a nice day.